Here, I'll give you a quick look at putting a pretty front end on Cassandra, doing some reporting and analytics on it. Jaspersoft has been doing business intelligence for the last 10 years, been working with Cassandra and with DataStax for the past 2 years. This is my only slide. The rest of the time, we'll do a brief demo so you can see what I'm talking about live. But the key takeaways are going to be if you want to try it yourself, it's all open source software. So jaspersoft.com, you can download our server and report designer and take a look at it. And then jasperforge.org is our open source community. And this is where you can download the connector to Cassandra. It's available under an AGPL license. You can take a look at the source and then give it a try and connect up to all of your data sources, whether those are Cassandra, I think applying to just about everybody here, but also other relational or non-relational systems as well. Okay, so with that, if we could switch over to the computer, I'll do a brief demonstration. Or maybe I'll do a brief demonstration. Let me see if I can find a browser. All right, one moment. There we go. So just to describe what I've got running here, this is an instance of the Jasperreport server. I happen to be running it on Amazon EC2, just so I have easy access to it. All right, for those of you with quick reaction time, you maybe saw the IP address of that site that I'm on. For the rest of you, I'm not going to mention what that IP address is, and hopefully no one will destroy the server during the demo here. Okay, no, we will never save this password. All right, so now I'm logged in as an administrator, and let me describe what I have already done in the background before we got started here now. I defined a connection to my Cassandra server. So in this case, we're using a JDBC connection. So I just go in here and I've defined my Cassandra connection. Simple URL, like it might be for any relational JDBC data source. It's pointed out to a system. Happens to also be running on Amazon EC2. And having done that, I'm going to create a new report or do a little bit of analysis on my existing data. Now, what I get presented with is a list of topics available to me. So this is designed for sort of less technical business users who understand the data, not folks who want to be writing SQL queries, that you just give them a web interface to do this. This assumes that you folks sitting in the audience have already gone through that first level of building a set of queries for them that they'll be able to use. Now, these will be parameterized queries. They can filter what data they're going to get, but you've already written the SQL queries for them. So they'll go in here and grab the topic that they're interested in and then start laying out a report. The key benefit here being that they don't have to go talk to you. You can just let them build their own reports. So say, all right, I want a report that's by account type. I want to see, I don't know, let's choose, how about account name? It'll default to giving me account, and so we'll break it down by account type. We'll say, no, I don't want to see it by that. I want to see it by industry, so we'll switch the grouping. And they'll be able to build up their own queries. So here I'm doing just a very simple bar chart. I've got pretty good control to change some of the details about the types of reports I'm going to create here. For those that really want total control over the report that you're creating, you would use our desktop tool, and it gives you complete flexibility, complete power, strikes fear in the hearts of your business users, so you don't want to give that tool to them. But with the web browser, they're fine. They'd be able to build up the reports they want, or go in and filter and say, well, I only want certain industries, let's create a filter on that. So it's a simple interface for them to build up whatever sort of reports they want to create. Thank you.